I'm going to try and make it through an episode about lightning without making a single electricity pun. I know, shocking. Well, I tried. Hey there, Julian here for DNews. Odds are, at some point in your life, you've seen a thunderstorm, but you've probably never taken part in one. The chances of being hit by lightning in the US in a given year are about 1 in 1,000,000. So unless you're one of the few who have been singled out by Zeus, you'll never know what it's like to have a storm cloud personally bully you. Lucky for you, I can tell you all about it in agonizing detail. Now, of course, on DNews, we've talked about lightning in the past and how it works, but to jolt your memory, I'll just re-explain that the conventional wisdom on lightning is it's caused when a static charge builds up in a cloud. It's still debated how exactly, but the simplest explanation is ice descending from the top of the cloud strips electrons from water droplets ascending from the bottom. And after a while, there's a massive negative charge at the base. The negative charge is so strong it actually repels electrons on Earth, pushing them down into the ground, and the surface of the Earth becomes positively charged. Like teenage lovebirds, opposites attract, and eventually the air, which serves as the stern parents in this analogy, can't keep the charges apart. They overcome the insulative properties of the air, a stream of electrons shoots down to the ground, and sparks fly. Isn't science romantic? But if someone's in the middle, they're gonna get hurt. Delivering up to 1 billion volts and billions of watts, a bolt of lightning can be fatal, and 10% of the time, it is. There are a few different ways a jolt from the heavens can finish you off. A number of your bodily systems rely on an electrical rhythm, and a zap from God's shock collar can throw those out of whack. One of the leading causes of death is cardiac arrest, though respiratory arrest and seizures aren't uncommon either. Even if your brain doesn't misfire, it can still be cooked by the intense heat of the bolt. If you're not killed, that same heat will probably leave third-degree burns at the points the lightning entered and exited your body. It could set your hair and clothes on fire, and any metal you're wearing, like necklaces or belt buckles, will also become superheated, leaving burns. Lightning also heats up the air around you up to 20,000 degrees Celsius, or over 3 times hotter than the surface of the sun. That rapid heating causes the air to expand. If you're farther away, you would hear it as a sound wave, aka a crack of thunder. But if you're standing in the middle of it, that expansion is actually a shock wave. It can send you flying, burst your eardrums, tear your clothes to shreds, and literally knock your shoes off. Yes, apparently being struck by lightning is excruciatingly painful with a touch of slapstick comedy. Effects of being struck by lightning can linger long after the storm has passed, and unless you're Tony Sikora, who got a bolt to the face and became a piano virtuoso, usually they're not superpowers. Chronic pain, headaches, personality changes, difficulty concentrating, and muscle twitches are just a few of the long-term effects reported by lightning strike victims. Not to mention the physical scars, which, in the case of Lichtenberg figures, actually resemble lightning itself. On the plus side, that's about 1,000,000 times more badass than getting a barbed wire tattoo. Obviously, this lightning stuff sounds a little dangerous, but what if we could control it? To find out more, check out this episode here.
A collection of these little drips of moisture condensed around tiny particles floating in the air. It's the particles that cause all of that electrical fun. The particles fly around, bumping and shaking inside of the cloud, and as they hit each other, the atoms bounce electrons off of one another and build up electrical charges.
We're close to 2 million subscribers, so statistically, 2 of you have been struck by lightning. If you have or know someone who has, tell us about it down in the comments, subscribe for more, and I will see you next time on DNews.